Autonomous unmanned marine vehicles, the popular technology of the last period in terms of their size, the load of weapons they carry and the cost. Such effective systems, especially if you are a country consisting of rocks and islands, are extremely critical technologies for destruction on the battlefield without being seen by the enemy. Many countries in the world are working on unmanned autonomous technologies. Especially in the military field, these increasing studies have gained momentum in the field of air vehicles. Countries that have achieved success in autonomous unmanned aerial vehicle technology have increased their efforts in other areas. Recently, studies on autonomous unmanned marine vehicles have been continuing in a small number of countries. Turkey is among the countries that are working on autonomous unmanned marine and even testing some vehicles. Especially for the border control between Turkey and Greece, consisting of rocks and islands in the Aegean Sea and the Eastern Mediterranean, very cost-effective solutions. Turkey, which has been developing missiles and high-tech radar systems by integrating them into these vehicles, has recently accelerated its work due to the increasing tensions in the Eastern Mediterranean. Among the Turkish companies that carry out projects on autonomous unmanned marine vehicles, YONCA-ONUK, Shipyard and ARS, Shipyard are among the companies that produce military ships, boats to many countries. Dozens of ships and boats produced by these companies are successfully serving in the Navy and Coast Guard of many countries. Let's get to know the autonomous unmanned armed naval vehicles developed by Turkey closely. Turkey's first naval unmanned combat tool, ULAQ, armed unmanned sea vehicle, reconnaissance, surveillance and intelligence above water warfare, asymmetric warfare, armed escort and force protection, facility security strategic headquarters in the execution of tasks such as vehicles and mobile command center from land or aircraft carriers, frigates, such as floating platforms can be used. It is equipped with 4 SIRIT and 2 L-UMTAS missiles provided by the National Missile Systems manufacturer Roketsan. ULAQ was equipped with different types of useful payloads such as electronic warfare, electronic mixing, and different communication and intelligence systems. However, it has the ability to conduct operations with other armed unmanned naval vehicles of a similar or different structure, as well as joint operations with UAVs and manned air vehicles. ULAQ, apart from being just a remotely controlled unmanned marine vehicle, it contains superior and AEGEAN capabilities with artificial intelligence and autonomous behavior features. Metexan Defense, which is one of the best companies in Turkey in autonomous and unmanned software issues, and ARS Shipyard, a company that has exported ships, boats to many countries in the world, developed it together. It is a cost-effective system for hunting enemies without landing on enemy coasts with guided anti-tank missiles located on the naval vehicle. Another of my systems is MARINE, which was developed in cooperation with Aselsan and Safine Shipyard and achieved many firsts in its field in the world. The MARINE unmanned naval vehicle has so far emerged as the best in its class among the unmanned naval vehicles developed in Turkey, decisively thanks to its electronic warfare capability. MARINE USV, which is intended to be used for defense attack purposes on the coastal and open seas, also stands out with its durability to difficult sea conditions thanks to its special hull design. Thanks to the hull design it has, the following weapon systems can be integrated into this marine vehicle in order to meet operational requirements. Guided missile, 12.7mm ball, lightweight torpedo, electronic attack and support systems, sonoboy system. Sankar. It is a marine platform developed together with the cooperation of YONCA-ONUK, Shipyard and Havelsan. Together with the versions to be developed, the Sankar, which will take on a character capable of performing reconnaissance surveillance, surface warfare, mine countermeasures tasks, will thus increase its operational diversity. The general characteristics of Sankar are as follows. Full length, 12.7 meters. Displacement, 9 tons. Top speed, 40 knots, 74.08 kilometers per hour. Cruising range, 400 nautical miles, 740 kilometers. Cruise time, 40 hours. This platform, which has the ability to operate up to 4 sea conditions, also provides convenience in integrating weapons and electronic systems of different types and purposes thanks to its modular structure. While providing this flexibility, thanks to being an unmanned system, it minimizes the human risk factor and realizes it cost-effectively. Another unmanned marine vehicle is the Salvo. It is being developed by DSM Shipyard. The Salvo is the fastest in its class. It stands out for its ability to shoot at moving targets with guided projectiles and machine guns. The main features of Salvo are as follows. Full length, 14.79 m. Width, 3.83 m. Maximum speed, 45 to 60 knots. Depending on the choice of diesel machine. The Salvo, driven by a diesel engine, uses 2 water jet propulsion systems. Looking at the integrated weapon configuration on the USV, a new naval remote-controlled weapon system with integrated Roketsan production, Yalman missile system and Aselsan production 12.7mm machine gun is seen. Salvo also has a mechanism for controlling via mobile vehicles on land or thanks to instant data flow from headquarters command centers. The vehicle has the ability to be launched from floating platforms such as amphibious landing craft, mine hunting ships, or corvettes. Following the armed air and land systems, Turkey is now aiming to introduce itself to the world about naval vehicles. By building large military ships, Turkey has the ability to control manned and unmanned platforms from the same center. Turkey can control all its ships from the ADVENT combat management system. This battle management system basically aims to make all ships move like a single ship. These unmanned autonomous vehicles, which have a lot of capabilities, will play an important role, especially in the Turkish-Greek border crisis.